So a student emailed me, and in the email they asked me, I've just spoken to my first clients to offer them analytical skills. However, after finishing my analysis, which I'll be doing in Python, I'm not too sure how I'm going to present my findings to my client. Do I have a meeting with them and show them a PowerPoint? Do I just email them a PDF, Word document containing graphs and conclusions from the analysis? Could you please inform me how you would approach this and perhaps give an example or template? So that email was sent to me by a student who's actually studying computer science, and great initiative that he spoke to me once before and asked me how we should get started in data analysis. And I said to him, just go and find a client, find a business problem and start an analysis. So it looks like he's gone ahead, found himself a client, and now wants to know how to go about presenting the findings once he's done the analysis. If you're new to my channel, we talk about all things data. So if you're a budding data analyst or even a seasoned pro or someone who just has an interest in data, then please do subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on any of the helpful tips and advice that I have to offer. So I'm really impressed with this student, the fact that he's gone off and found himself a client and now he wants to know how to present the findings, because that's actually something that's overlooked. You know, as he says, does he do a presentation? Does he just email them a PDF or a Word document? What does he do? I mean, if you've never done this before, what is the right thing to do? Now, the first thing to say is there's no right thing to do, but there's a recommended way to do things. And my recommendation would be to present your findings to the client, okay? So that also means that you can explain and you can answer questions. And if there's things that they're uncertain about, then you can at least elaborate on them. If you just send them a Word document or a PDF document, ideally, they may not understand it, they may not have time to read it. Whereas if you book time in their diary and say, look, I've done the analysis, I'd like to come and present it to you, okay? And book some time in their diary and take them through at least an hour, so it gives you sufficient time to talk about what you did and what you found, okay? So try and get yourself a time in with the client to present. That is the best way. Obviously, if you can't, if the client's too busy, then do send them a PDF document. What I would do typically is summarize the findings of your study up front in a very exact summary and then give them the more detailed presentation, because you'll find that they're too busy sometimes to read the whole thing. But if they read the exact summary and it interests them, then they're more likely to read the rest of the document. The second part of his question was, how should he structure it? So the first thing I would do is, if you imagine you're producing a presentation, the first section is about what were you asked to do. Reiterate and replay to the client what you were asked to do by the client. So if it was to find out if customers are happier coming to my store before I made the change compared to after, or do they shop more before I made the change compared to after, then, you know, replay that back. So replay, what were you asked to do? Then the next section of your presentation is, how did you do it? So what did you do, okay? What data did you use? How did you analyze that data? Are there any particular statistical techniques that you had? Don't go into too much detail, because obviously your clients that you're presenting to won't be as technical as you, so they won't know, don't mention too many technical terms. So keep it very top level and send them a sort of summary of what you did, how you did it, in terms of, like, you know, the data sources, the analysis that you run. Then the next section is about what you found, okay? So what did you find, okay? So a lot of people try to build up to it. I literally just like to say, top line, this is what I found, and then explain the findings, how I found that out, okay? The next section really should be about what have you found from the analysis that you've done. And the final section, which most people omit, because they think that if they've shown what they found, then the business can go away and know what to do with it. If you can, and I appreciate if you're a student, you may find it difficult, but if you can do a bit of research and try and work out what does it mean for them, okay? So if you actually wrote in your heading of your slides, what does it mean for you, the business owner is more likely to take notice, because now they're like, okay, what does this actually mean for me? This is what you've done, this is what you found, and what does it mean for me? And then explain what it means to them. So if it says something like, you know, the changes that you made actually didn't result in more customers shopping with you, or customers spending more with you, or whatever it is, then, you know, maybe it wasn't a good change to do, or maybe they didn't spend more with you, but actually they bought higher basket sizes, okay? So they came as often, but they per basket, per transaction, they spent more with you, okay? So you just need to explain to them what that analysis means to them as a business, and if they could do anything different, or if they should carry on doing the same things. So I'm really glad that the student followed through and has found himself a client and now wants advice on what to do after he's done the analysis. And I'm hoping that he will take this advice and, you know, it will help him towards becoming a data analyst. So thank you for watching my channel. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do share and like the video. And of course, please do subscribe to the channel. Thank you.